A city on the verge of greatness. A new type of city, based not on the man, but on the automobile. The car. The symbol of freedom and vitality. Where every man can own his own home, and have room to breathe, and not be overlooked by his neighbors. A city where a man's home is his castle. A quarter acre of the dream made possible by victory. A city of opportunists. A city of dreams, where Hollywood will shape the thoughts and desires of the entire planet. A city of pioneers. A city of dreamers. City of undercurrents, where not everything is as it seems. A 20th century city that will become a model for the world. A city that has no boundaries, that will stretch as far as the eye can see. In the Marine Corps, you deal with the chain of command. Mistakes get made, but you deal with them. You know what you're fighting for and that you're on the same team. But dealing with corruption is like chasing shadows. You never know whether the guy you're talking to is on the pad, or whether it's your partner, or maybe even the watch commander. So who do you trust, Cole? I made up my mind a long time ago.
KGBL calling car, 14 Adam. 14 Adam, come in.
Go ahead, KGPL.
14 Adam, see the detective, an ambulance shooting at 6th and Industrial Street. Unit 16 William requests uniform assistance for an evidence search. 14 Adam, code 2.
Roger, 14 Adam, en route.
Here we go again. They don't request uniforms for an evidence search unless there's some kind of catch.
Ever the optimist.
From the beam of sunshine himself.
Floyd Rose, homicide. You my backup?
Yes, sir. Phelps and Dunn, Wilshire Division.
We had a shooting took place down this alleyway. We have the Vic, Scooter Payton, a Negro male, bagged up and on his way to Central Morgue. Witness says a tall white guy, our shooter, put two in the Vic's head and then threw his piece. I need you guys to try and recover the gat.
You want us to look anywhere in particular?
Give it your best shot, guys. The dead guy's a lowlife. I'm not expecting any miracles here.
And if we recover the weapon?
Bag it and return it to technical services.
You hurried up, Floyd. We
I'm
got
out
places
of here.
To be.
Happy hunting.
This is a fist hump. Just going through the motions.
You're probably right. Let's just get it over and done.
All right, have it your way. We'll search right up to the back wall. If you still don't come up with anything, come find me and we'll talk it out. Two heads are always better than one. Look at this junk.
Not my job to pick through other people's trash.
What have you got, Phelps? Anything?
Shooter put him up against the wall and blew his brains out.
Hell of a way to go.
Doesn't really matter how you go once you're gone.
Don't get all deep on me, Phelps. I tell you, I'm jinxed. I always get landed with this crap.
Ralph, there's something on the rooftop.
How the hell did you see that?
Reflection in the window. Looks like it might be our weapon. I'm gonna see if I can find a way up there.
All right, don't hurt yourself. The gun's up on the roof, right? So we need to find a way up.
What kind of chumps do these homicide guys think we are?
Smith & Wesson, serial S71893. Two rounds fired, and instead of dropping it down a drain, our shooter hoists it up here. Interesting guy.
We should follow up on this now, before the perp tries to leave town.
We have the gun, Cole. Let's take it back to Central. We could get a commendation.
We could show some initiative, Ralph, and see if we can come up with an owner.
That's a long shot, Cole.
It's a pretty fancy gun. You know a local gun store?
Sure. There's a place a couple of blocks from here.
Are you sure about this? It's not really our gig.
No harm in doing some digging. The suits didn't seem to give much of a damn.
Such a little Boy Scout, Cole. You can't wait to get out of that uniform, can you?
You'd rather round up drunks and help old ladies across the road?
I'd rather get through the day without the captain's foot up my ass.
It'll be fine, Ralph. You worry too much.
Wake up, Cole. Wake up, Cole.
Doesn't tell me anything.
Wake up, Cole. Wake up, Cole.
Dr. Fontaine, could I have a word?
Of course, young man.
I really enjoyed your lecture, Doctor. Psychiatry seems to have a tremendous amount to offer.
Why, thank you. I'm always happy to receive acknowledgement for my work. The mind is the last great mystery in medicine. Are you thinking of specializing, Mr.
Sheldon, or Courtney Sheldon? I'm only in second year, Doctor. They fast-tracked me a year because of my experience during the war.
Ah.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. Battle fatigue and collapse under duress. Can it be helped?
I would say yes, given the right set of circumstances. Trauma forces the mind to close down, retreat in on itself. We try to find ways to unlock the mind again through a combination of therapy and drug treatment. Hypnosis and therapy are powerful tools in the right hands, Sheldon.
I've been to visit some of the guys at the VA hospital. A good friend of mine He's so far away. It's like he's wandering.
You went through a lot together.
Yes, Doctor.
Give me his details and I'll make a prognosis. I have a number of clinics in Los Angeles, Courtney Sheldon. And your penance, for your friend's help, is to come and work at one of them in your spare time. With what little spare time a medical student has. Is that a deal?
Is it ever? I can't thank you enough.
I'm not promising a cure, Courtney. I want you to remember that. Every physician has patients that he cannot hope to cure, for whom he can only smooth the path to death.
Wake up, Cole.
Officers Phelps and Dunn, can you tell us anything about this gun?
Smith & Wesson, Model 27, registered Magnum. Chambered for .357, nickel-plated with pearl grips. Same gun used by General Patton.
You're not suggesting he's the owner?
No, I'm not.
You seem to know a lot about the weapon.
I ought to. I sold it. You know, this piece will stop a rhino. These babies are only available special order. Here's my Smith & Wesson order book.
You mind if I take a look?
Be my guest. This is about something bad, right?
Model 27 with pearl grips, Cole. You see it on there?
We're in luck, Errol Schroeder. 203 South Glass Street. Ordered the gun in February 46. Thanks, you've been a big help.
Anytime. Always happy to help out the LAPD.
Do we call it in?
Let's see if he's at home. Owning the gun doesn't prove he pulled the trigger.
Okay. In for a penny, in for a pound. Lead the way, Gunga Din.
Wasn't so hard, was it? Just because we're in uniform doesn't mean we can't use our initiative.
I guess so. Seems a little too good to be true. One-of-a-kind murder weapon bought locally using a real name? If Schroeder's our shooter, he's no criminal mastermind.
Most of them aren't. That's why they get caught. Two out of every three crimes are done on impulse.
Another fact from the Phelps Encyclopedia of Thin Air. really are full of it.
Schroeder, apartment 2.
What do you guys want?
I'm Officer Cole Phelps. This is Officer Dunn, Wilshire Division. You're the owner of a Smith & Wesson Model 27, nickel-plated with pearl grips?
I might be. What of it?
Then you'll be surprised to know that Scooter Payton was murdered tonight. With your gun.
You're out of your mind. Scooter, he works for me. I have that gun here in my drawer. What the fuck is going on here?
You're under arrest, Schroeder. Cuff him, Ralph.
No way. You're not taking me down for this.
I hardly felt it. He's lucky he caught me off guard.
Keep an eye on him, Ralph. I'm gonna take a look around. List of names and a series of numbers. Floyd Rose's name is in this book.
Phelps, we can come out of this all bright and shiny with a commendation. Or stick our schlongs in a hornet's nest. Call it in, partner. And leave the book where you found it.
Officer Phelps, badge 1247, requesting.
Fucking sons of bitches, get in this line now before I lose my temper.
Excuse me, Sergeant, but...
Excuse me? Fuck you. You say another word and I'll break your fucking head and have you in the brig.
Some of us are here for...
I know why you're here, asswipe. I'm having a bad day, Private. Some people don't seem to want to get on this bus.
I didn't ask for your help.
He didn't ask for your help. Can you believe this guy? Who are you two? Abbott and Costello?
We're here for OCS, Sergeant.
So it's the three fucking stooges and you're here for OCS. God help this fucking country and the USMC. The Japanese will do the world a favor and kill you quickly. All three of you are on report. What are your fucking names?
Phelps.
Kelso.
Merrill. Any other gentlemen for OCS? OCS is at Elliott. You take the Camp Elliott bus over there. This bus is for MCRD. This bus is for men who want to fight.
Well, you picked the right place, Cole. A city that needed an honest cop like a thirsty man needed water. You'd heard the stories, but you weren't interested. You were here to fight the good fight, solve cases, right wrongs. The force is like politics. There's no sitting on the fence. You have to choose sides. A brown paper envelope, or a Greyhound ticket to Palookaville. It could only ever end one way.
All units to 211 in progress and shots fired at Westlake Savings and Loan, 1415 West 3rd Street. Unit to handle identifying code 3.
We'll take that. It's only a couple blocks from
14 here. Adam calling KGPL. We'll handle the 211.
Roger that, 14 Adam. Be advised, suspects are armed and dangerous.
Roger KGPL. 14 Adam on route.
LAPD, put down your weapons. The bank is surrounded. I'm offering you
a chance, copper. I got you covered, Cole.
We got them all? I think we got them, Cole. Should be all clear. Lieutenant Hopkins says anytime you reach for the shotguns, you're either going to end up dead or wearing a citation. So I guess...
It's okay, Ralph. You did well in there. I'm glad you have my back. Man couldn't ask for a better partner.
This kind of opportunity comes along once in a lifetime, Hank. I have to grasp it.
You have to survive at first, Cole. You're the veterans. The Japs love to shoot officers.
If I can make a name for myself in this war, my future...
Thinking of taking on a company of the Emperor's finest single-handed? You don't seem the Sergeant York type to me.
When I need your opinion, Kelso, I'll ask for it.
They talk about officers like you in boot camp, Cole. They call it the Custer Syndrome. Guys who go around dreaming of fame and glory and getting all of their men killed in the process.
Our duty is to lead, Kelso.
And their duty is to die for your wonderful future?
Cole Phelps and Jack Kelso. With some people, it's as simple as chemistry. Two guys who should have been friends. Their personalities got in the way. Phelps, a good guy, but wound way too tight. And Kelso, a quiet man who could never walk away from a fight.
Well, it's a shame you don't like to talk about it, Cole.
Ralph, friends who want to stay friends don't discuss religion or politics. And in my case, you can add the war to that.
I know that bum. Wendell Bowers. I put him away before he jumped parole. Get after him, Phelps. I'll head him off in the car.
Wendell Bowers! Stop! LAPD!
You can go screw yourself.
Watch it!
He's hiding in the alley! Bowers! Hold it right there!
Stop now or I will shoot! I won't tell you again, Wendell.
Jesus, Doug! Watch your fire!
Don't want to do this, Wendell. Get down from there right now!
Give it up, Wendell!
Stay the hell away from me!
You've got to be kidding!
You fucking asked for it! No way I'm going back inside. I've done my time.
It's over, Bowers.
You assholes already screwed me once.
Give it up, Bowers. There's nowhere left to go.
Looks like we've got the place to ourselves.
Nice work, Cole. You run track in high school?
Part of the tradition of the Marine Corps and being an officer in the Marine Corps is the ability to make tough decisions. The right decision is not always the popular one. The right decision will get the men you care about killed. These ratings and your ability to give them frankly and truthfully directly affect your chances of successfully becoming a Marine officer. Candidate Phelps, you have the floor. Esprit de Corps. Merrill, 10. Franklin, 8. Weiss, 8. Donahoe, 6. Kowalski, 6. Hudson, 5. Kelso, 2. Leadership. Donahoe, 8. Franklin, 7. Merrill, 6. Kowalski, 6. Weiss, 5. Hudson, 5. Kelso, 1. Candidate Kelso!
I'm sorry, Captain, but I joined the Marine Corps to fight the enemy, not get involved in this schoolboy chicken shit.
Kelso, in my office, now!
For every cop, there's the case that makes you. Gives you that leg up, gets you recognized as the shining new star in the squad. The case that you solve that shows that you have the gumption, the gung-ho, the get-up-and-go to make you stand out from your average rank-and-file patrolman. This could be the one, Cole.
LAPD, could you stand clear of the body, please? Has anyone called an ambulance?
We've called an ambulance and the police, but I'm afraid he's dead.
Okay, stand further back or move along. It's your choice, but make it quick, people.
Hey, Cole. You got here quick.
My beat crosses 7th Street.
Okay. You're first reporting, then. We'll get a perimeter going and move the crowd on. You better see what you can find out before the homicide dicks show up. I'll be with you in a moment.
I swear. Broad daylight. Crowded street. I've seen everything.
Everybody stay back. Let us do our job.
C. Galetta. Layaway receipt. Pearl earrings. Made out to Bank of Arcadia.
People have anything better to do?
Officer, please, tell me what's going on.
FN Browning, serial number 01138. Might need to run by a gun store.
Eagleson's gun store is a couple blocks from here.
Shell casings. These look like 32s.
The guy in the crowd thinks he saw something, Cole. You better take a statement.
What do you
think? You look like you were a big pain in the neck. Now I have a much lower opinion.
Sir, I'm Officer Phelps. What exactly did you see?
I heard the shots. I thought it was a car backfiring. I saw a girl run into the shoe store.
Speak to the witness before homicide arrives, Phelps. If you think she's lying, don't be afraid to get forceful. Verbally, of course. And don't accuse her of anything without proof. Lawyers love that shit. And if you're sure she's straight up, try the general approach. See what you can coax out of her.
Can I help you, sir?
I'm Officer Phelps, miss. I'm here about the shooting. Did you know the victim?
He was my boss. Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage's first name?
Everett.
And you are?
Galleta. Clovis Galleta.
Do you think you could tell me exactly what happened, miss?
I look around the shops at lunch. I was in a store when Mr. Gage, my boss, bursts in yelling that I'm late on my lunch.
And?
We came back. I was angry. I walked in front. I heard shots. I turned and saw Mr. Gage fall.
National News.
worldwide March of Dimes campaign in Washington, Mrs. Truman and her daughter Margaret take part in the ceremonies at the Capitol by dropping theirs and the president's dimes in the Missouri bottle. Miss Truman later made an appeal for contributions to the Infantile Paralysis Fund drive to replace $7.5 million spent during the severe 1946 epidemics. And in New York, little Nancy Drury with the big cop was once a polio victim, but now she's the pinup girl for the current campaign, seeking to raise $25 million. Little Miss Drury of Louisville, Kentucky, and her 6'8" escort...
You're lying, Miss Galetta. You know what happened and why. You're going to tell me.
There's nothing to tell. I've done nothing wrong. How can you prove different?
Your pearl earrings, Miss Galetta. You've been paying for them for a whole year. Stop lying and tell me what happened at the jewelry store.
Oh, God! I won't lose the earrings, will I?
You could lose your freedom, you little fool, if you don't stop obstructing a murder investigation.
Mr. Kalu. Edgar Kalu. He runs the jewelry store. He's showing me a lovely watch. Mr. Gage bursts in. Mr. Kalu gets very angry with Mr. Gage, and they start yelling at each other. Mr. Gage tells me that all of the things in the store are junk, nickel-plated, made in Japan, and yells at me to get back to work.
Then what happened?
We get back here, and I hear a loud bang. Mr. Gage clutches at his back. I hear another bang, and another, and another. Mr. Gage falls to his knees. It looked very painful.
Which jewelry store?
Hartfield's. Broadway, between 5th and 6th.
Did you see the person who shot Mr. Gage?
Of course I did. Mr. Kalu looked very angry. He kept firing the gun. He kept pulling the trigger. He threw the gun in a bin and turned and walked away.
You're making me angry, Miss Galetta. Is that what you want? Tell me why Mr. Kalu shot Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage hates Jews. A lot of people do. It's not my fault if he has nice things.
How many shots did you hear, Miss Galetta?
It's difficult to remember. It sounded like there were so many, and they were so loud.
I need you to concentrate, Miss Galetta. Even minor details can become important later on.
Well, there was one bang, and then another, and then three very quickly, close together. Five.
Thank you for your help, ma'am. You've been very brave. We'll need you to make a formal statement about what happened, Mr. Gage.
Does that mean I can still collect my... Never mind. Yes, officer, I'll make a statement.
We have the murder weapon.
And the murder. The girl saw it all. Our killer works at a jewelry store called Hartfield's.
That's a couple of blocks from here.
Thinking what I'm thinking.
Tate, maintain the perimeter.
Thank you. officers. What can I do you for?
Officers Phelps and Dunn, sir, Wilshire Division. We need you to trace a serial number.
Sure. What's the make and model?
F.N. Browning, model 1922. The serial number is 01138.
You don't say. Well, I didn't sell it. Europeans love them, but it's pretty rare you find one over here. Although I did have one in here a couple of weeks back.
Remember the owner?
Yeah. Callu. Edgar Callu was his name. Thing looks like he'd never been fired, but he brought it in here for cleaning anyway. Then he bought a box of cartridges and he left.
You know where we can find Mr. Callu?
Told me he was on his lunch break. Said he worked at Hartfield's jewelry store just up on Broadway.
Thanks for your help.
Can I interest you in a new watch?
Officer Cole Phelps, are you Edgar Callu?
No. Mr. Callu is out back. He said he'd lie down. I'll buzz him for you.
Son of a bitch! Go, Cole, go!
Hurry, officer! He's getting away!
Callu! Get back here!
Officer Cole Phelps, are you Edgar Callu?
No. Mr. Callu is out back. He said he'd lie down. I'll buzz him for you.
Son of a bitch! Go, Cole, go!
Hurry, officer! He's getting away!
Callu! Get back here!
He wants a five-star goddamn wedding.
Too late, Callu! Make it worse, Callu!
Edgar Callu, you're under arrest for the murder of Everett Gage.
The case that makes you, and the case that breaks you. The one you never solve, the one that keeps you awake at night. The case that gnaws at your guts and ruins your marriage. The case that keeps you propping up a bar as you relive the what-ifs, the might-have-beens, the half-leads, and the half-truths. The case that other cops murmur about whenever you walk past. The case you never, ever discuss.
God's mill may grind slowly, but it grinds finely, son. I hear it's you who nabbed our malefactor from the shooting yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Then tell me, Boyle. I hear you're quite the climber, a man of initiative. How would you like a chance at smiting this man with the sword of justice?
You're asking me to conduct the interview, sir?
I am, young Phelps. You've only been with us a short time, and you've assembled yourself a stellar arrest record. Not to mention the fine work you did in the war, sending heathens back to the hell they came from. But I'm curious as to whether you can turn your hand to interrogation. takes a certain animal cunning, lad. Do you think you might be ready for that?
Yes, sir. I think I am.
Good man. You need many things for a conviction, young Phelps. A motive, opportunity, hard evidence, and best of all, a confession. If you fail in the former, you can always use a modicum of violence to obtain the latter. How are you feeling, lad?
Fine, sir.
Very good. The evidence is overwhelming. May the cat eat him and the cat be eaten by the devil. Bring me a confession, young Phelps. This is your chance. Don't fail me.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. You followed Everett Gage and the girl back to the shoe store. You put 5 rounds in Gage's back.
Gage was a bastard. Whatever he got what was coming. But it had nothing to do with me.
You shot Gage, and we know why. We can put you at the scene.
You can't prove anything.
We know all about the argument. Miss Galetta made a statement.
You're counting on the girl? You think her testimony's gonna stand up in court?
You're going to the gas chamber, Edgar.
That Jew-hating fuck couldn't leave me alone. I had a sale. That girl was ready to buy.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Lying, Kalu. I think you lent Gage money, and he owed you payment.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Like I made a mistake.
I'm done with you. Go flap your gums somewhere else. I want my lawyer. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. You followed Everett Gage and the girl back to the shoe store. You put 5 rounds in Gage's back.
Gage was a bastard. Whatever he got what was coming. But it had nothing to do with me.
You shot Gage, and we know why. We can put you at the scene.
You can't prove anything.
We know all about the argument. Miss Galetta made a statement.
You're counting on the girl? You think her testimony's gonna stand up in court?
You're going to the gas chamber, Edgar.
That Jew-hating fuck couldn't leave me alone. I had a sale. That girl was ready to buy.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You left-wing leaning parasite. You expect me to sit here and listen to your drivel?
You call me that? You sit there and you call me those names, you goddamn goy putt snatcher! You and that stump Gage!
Why did you do it, Mr. Kalu?
Gage. He's in the Chamber of Commerce. He's in with all those momsers. He blocked every proposal I ever put forward. Kike this and kike that. He's been trying to ruin my business for years.
Edgar Kalu, I'm charging you with the first degree murder of Everett Gage. I respect your beliefs and your right to hold them. I hope for your sake. Jury can commute to murder in the second degree. May God have mercy on you, sir.
Masterfully done, Officer Phelps. It is just, Officer Phelps. Isn't it, lad?
Yes, sir.
Then let me have a word with the Chief of Police, young Phelps. The department needs heroes. A shining, honest face the public can admire. I applaud a man with your talent for unwavering justice. Back to your duties for now, Boyle. But here's a piece of advice. Get yourself 2 suits, get them pressed. You'll be needing them.
Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine. I'm here to learn, Detective. Oh, he's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Intense.
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earl, chief detective and advice.
Are they all dressed like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star.
And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out. And now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with
you,
sir.
That's an order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. Really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why are you war heroes always so modest? I've partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right? Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside now. I'm going to start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousing vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out. Come on, Phelps.
Hey, I gave his wife a tap. I said all's fair in love and war.
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
Isn't that the cop who won a medal and is solving all the cases?
Mary says he'll sing. Only if I guarantee he walks.
You know this place?
Sure. Near the old gasworks and signal depot in the warehouse district.
Correct. Is on. Bounce! Leave him be!
760.
All units of 159.
Tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bukowski?
We have to work together. Don't be so touchy.
Grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Reno CS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant. Fought in the Okinawa campaign. Wounded. Shipped back home. Year on the beat, down here. So you won the Silver Star. I don't want to talk about it. Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa. No, you were up there all night, draped in a knife between your teeth, gun at the ready, finished. The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski.
What did you do?
I kept the streets of LA safe for the people.
Yeah. Now I can.
All units of 459 just occurred at 6th and Saris. Any unit to handle, code 2, identified.
11K, go ahead, KGPL.
11K, a 459 suspect just left 6th and Saris. Suspect is a...
Up on the roof, officer. He has a mask on his face. I caught sight when he shoved past me, but be careful. I saw him waving a gun.
Now, make it easy on yourself.
Get the hell away from me!
Let's negotiate.
How long do you think you can hold out?
That you, Bukowski? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped the full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Nice day for it.
How long are you gonna keep me here, sir?
Always the same two of you. How about you?
I've got a mystery sample waiting at the lab. Practical Joker say it's contaminated.
I don't think this is my guess.
Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday. I think this is going to help us.
Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood. You got a wide shot of the car and its surrounds?
Listen, I've never met, so I'm just gonna go ahead and say this once. You don't tell me how to do my job, and I won't tell you how to do yours.
Brand name might give us something to go on. Old, married, sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here? Happier times, I guess. Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it.
I was married by a judge. I should have asked for a jury.
Hey, Flatfoot, you're looking to get rid of that old crate? I'll give you a nickel for it.
Thank you.
advice?
Have a word with the witness. It's not often we get eyeballs in a case like this.
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Do you want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie?
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Not that I was gonna steal anything. Maybe I took a look. But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars are parked here regularly, so it kind of stood out.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. If you're done here, we'll head over there now.
Doc? Detective Phelps. What have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. Victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
No freight rolling through here till we're done. And we're still punching the clock.
Help me out.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. If you're done here, we'll head over there now.
What's going on, Detective? Something bad happened here?
We're going to notify the wife. You seem to have it under control here.
Yeah, I got this.
Bunker Hill Avenue. You know where that is?
Behind Bunker Hill. A couple blocks north of Central Station.
So, what do we tell the wife?
Play it by the book. No stiff yet, so let's see how it plays out.
Shots fired off speed tap. Chateau and Valencia.
Could be a car theft gone wrong. Make Black drive somewhere lonely, then give him a tap.
But why we?
Obviously, someone got a little heavy-handed.
It's the wrong way around.
Well, how so, genius?
Where is Adrian? If you've gone to all the trouble to steal the car, and it goes wrong, you leave the body behind, not the car.
You got something there, folks. It doesn't add up.
About the guy on the crossing yesterday?
No, what happened?
Over on Lincoln Avenue. This guy's driving along and his oil light comes on. He stops the car and gets out. He pops the hood and...
he's on a rail crossing.
Oh, you got it. He's got his head under there checking the oil. The Southern Pacific freight slams into his car doing 90 miles an hour. The car came to a rest more than a mile down the track.
What a pointless waste of life.
You'll get plenty of blood and guts and mindless stupidity working traffic, folks. And who needs a Second Amendment when we'll give a goddamn fool the license to get behind the wheel of an automobile?
Fire 11K, we'll handle the help call. Go ahead, KGPL.
I see you motherfuckers. Come on up here and get us.
What is all this?
Traffic stop from hell. Trolley unit pulls these guys over. Finds a trunk full of hardware like you can do. Loose. Bullets start flying. And they snatch up the guns and one of the cops. Hit the high ground and make their scene.
And the officer?
Up there. Still alive, we think. Who knows for how long. We'll keep him busy if you can find a way up, sir.
Thank you.
11K. I've been involved in a shooting. It's code 4 here, but suspects are down, and I need an ambulance at Chateau and Valencia. Also notify detective headquarters. I'll need the coroner. My partner and I are okay.
11K, roger on the ambulance and coroner. Detective headquarters will be notified. All units, 11K reports code 4 on the shooting in Chateau and Valencia. Code 4.
If it's a kidnapping, why leave the victim's ID? If it's a murder, why leave the car? The evidence doesn't add up.
Free lesson, folks. Evidence will only get you so far. You ask me, the whole thing feels hinky as hell.
What I wouldn't give to have your powers of intuition.
Don't worry, kid. Keep watching the master and you'll get there one day.
Gotta stop or put your fucking foot down.
Let's go introduce ourselves. You talk to her, Phelps. I'm no good at this shoulder to cry on stuff.
Just a minute.
LAPD, Mrs. Black. May we come in? We have some bad news and we'd rather discuss this in private.
I'm Margaret Black. We can discuss this in the living room. Please come in.
We're gonna have a look around, then we'll talk. Kavanaugh's? So who brought this home? Maybe Adrian was a patron. R and I should have an address.
Lie down, make yourself comfortable. So, you're a friend of Courtney's?
Yes, doctor. He seems very concerned about you. I have these visions, these blinding visions. I can't get them out of my head. My skull, it feels like it's in a vice.
I'm going to give you something to calm your nerves.
want to take you on a journey. A journey back. I want you to remember the good things about your past. Occasions that made you laugh. Times that made you smile.
Take a smarter man than me to connect that. Not much help.
This was only recently installed, not 2 days ago.
Maybe it's time we took a look around outside.
No use leaving the thing half finished. So the pipe missing from Mr. Black's heater is the same one that killed him. Huh. Seems like the assailant is a little closer to home. Ticket to Seattle and a suitcase gone missing. Someone couldn't wait to get out of this house. This must be Adrian's. Stenzel. So the glasses are a match. Thank you. To my Adrian. This thing gets more and more interesting. Separate bedrooms, separate pictures. What gives here? Message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
Certainly, Detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's bar, corner of Aliso and Hewitt, south side of Union Station.
Thanks. Your husband drives a blue Lincoln, Mrs. Black?
That's correct.
The car has been found abandoned, and I'm afraid there are signs of foul play.
I knew something was wrong when he didn't come home.
We believe your husband may be injured. We found a pipe on the scene with blood on it.
Oh, no! My poor Adrian!
Do you think you could answer some questions now, Mrs. Black?
Of course. However I can help. Are you trying to find my husband?
Your husband frequents Kavanaugh's bar?
How did you know that? Adrian practically lives there after work.
KTI Radio reminds you, make sure to sign up for your social security number. Applications available at your local post office.
So Adrian spends a lot of time there.
Up until recently, he's been away in Seattle a lot on business.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? What an awful thing to say! I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Is there anyone who can vouch for that?
Well, no. I was here alone. I cooked Adrian's dinner and waited, but he never came home.
Was your husband wearing his glasses when he left here yesterday?
Yes, he just bought a new pair.
Go on.
I kept telling him to throw those old ones away. He tried to repair them with tape. They looked terrible.
We found a receipt in the trunk of your husband's car for a live pig. This receipt was made out to an F. Morgan.
A pig? Adrian runs a tool business. That would be Frank Morgan. God knows what he's up to.
What makes you say that about Morgan, ma'am?
He's the foreman at my husband's plant. Very shady character. I've told Adrian he needs to keep his distance from the staff. They're always out drinking together.
Did your husband tell you where he was going last night?
All he said was he was gonna meet Frank for a drink.
So nothing out of the usual then?
Well, he came home early from work. He never comes home early. And he went out early too. He normally never leaves for the bar till about 7.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
You and your husband are in separate bedrooms. What gives? Did you want him out of the way, Margaret?
No, I did not. My husband and I may have drifted apart, but it wasn't my choice.
We'll keep you informed, Mrs. Black.
Please do, Detective.
Don't seem to have the happiest home life.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet to throw him out. If this hadn't happened, they could have stayed miserable together forever.
You think she could have killed him?
She sure as hell doesn't seem the type. Stranger things have happened.
Any century unit 415 possible window case. The 7th and Flower unit to handle code 3 identified.
No, you don't.
We were at school together. How about you buy me a drink for old time's sake?
Call these grits?
You looking for someone?
Two club sandwich. Was taken to ass, locked up the
barnyard with the greatest of care. What's a special with it?
We don't find you.
You know Frank Morgan?
Release finds you handy.
Sure. Frank's your regular. He's a loner in the back.
J.W. Robinson are having sale. Don't you know?
Frank Morgan? Who's asking? Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know him.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that. Tough break.
We found Black's car abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk-off, Phelps. You're lying, Morgan. You were there.
And you're talking out your ass, detective. How about you prove I was out at that rail yard?
Sorry. Sometimes you have to shake the tree to see what falls out. I think you were in on it, Morgan. You drove down there, and you let Black have it.
Ooh, I'm a bad boy. Is that the best you got?
When did you last see Adrian?
Hell, I don't know. I had plenty to drink last night. Things are a little sketchy.
If he was on his way to meet you when he went missing, you're gonna have to do a lot better than I don't recall.
He had a couple and then left, I guess. Maybe he had to go meet someone. That's the best I can do.
This doesn't add up, Morgan. Your excuses don't help. Let's see how you enjoy the LAPD taking an interest in your life.
You want my opinion? We tail Morgan. I say he's lying, and whatever hole he's got Adrian stashed in, he's got to go back there sometime.
Sure left his drink in a hurry. I bet he wishes he'd rehearsed that story better now.
Opinion?
He sure left his drink in a hurry. I bet he wishes he'd rehearsed that story better now.
Funny idea of what keeping a low profile means, Phelps.
Why are you putting the siren on? Where are you taking us, Mr. Morgan?
Check the place out. Come on. Day one of the big time, and you're already tailing drunks home from the bars. You having fun yet? I told you it was non-stop glamour work to traffic, didn't I?
I'm just trying to learn.
Oh, come on, Phelps. Save the creepy teacher's pet stuff for Leary. Won't work on me.
Apartment 2.
All right. Let's pay our friend a visit, see if he's missed us yet.
Who the hell is that?
Will you relax? Jesus, Adrian, I told you, we're in the clear. I'll get it. Ah, shit. It's over, Morgan. Mr. Black?
LAPD, give yourself up now!
I knew it!
Phelps, go after him. I'll try and head him off in the car. Remember, the gun will go after the door.
There's no point running, Adrian. Mr. Black, get back here right now. It's over, Adrian.
Why not just come clean with her, Black? Why the melodrama?
I thought it would be easier.
No, it just got a whole lot harder. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and fraud. We'll see what the DA has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose chase like this.
You're gonna lose your wife, lose your job, and probably end up in the big house.
I hope she was worth it, Adrian.
That turned out to be quite some case, huh? Adrian, what an idiot. You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style, too. Well done, detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up and you learn from Bukowski here, you could go a long way in this department. Okay, we're gonna keep this short. I'm already late for the DA. First up, Phelps, Bukowski. We got a report of a brand new Packard abandoned in an empty lot off 2nd Street between Olive and Grand. PR is one Oswald Jacobs says the vehicle was dumped in his backyard. There's a patrolman on site. Get down there and see what you can turn up. Any questions? Good, get going.
You are so bad.
Better go earn our pathetic wages.
Rimsky, O'Halloran. Intelligence has information on a stolen car racket.
Mouthpiece for strips off me at the grand jury. Case got thrown out. Now the DA won't like it.
I think he's a bit of a gangster. But...
Phelps, traffic.
I'm Officer Houlihan. Car's down the alleyway, detectives.
We got a call about an abandoned vehicle.
Yes, sir. The car has flags. Might be some kind of diplomatic vehicle.
Has anyone touched this vehicle since you arrived?
No. And that Jacobs bird over there was on station before I got here.
We'll talk with him in a moment. Give us some time to look the place over.
Sure, take your time. He's a sore-headed old son of a bitch anyway.
It's owned by the Argentinian embassy. Stealing the wheels is for amateurs. Car ring would have stripped it in a warehouse.
Empty.
Nothing significant.
I heard this is a triple homicide. Is that true?
Optimistic, Cole.
I don't know why you're doing that, buddy, but I wish you'd stop.
Combination wrench. Must have used it to remove the wheel lugs.
Seems irrelevant.
Oswald Jacobs?
That's right.
What exactly happened here, Mr. Jacobs?
Last night, I was looking out of my window. I like to keep an eye on what's going on.
I can understand that.
You see this empty lot? Damn kids play stickball here. Always breaking my windows. Always asking for their ball back.
Can we get back to the car, Mr. Jacobs?
Don't be impatient, Sonny. Anyway. Last night, I see this brand spanking new Packard up on bricks.
Did you see who stole the Packard?
Hell yes, I did. I saw three goddamn Mexicans going to work on it.
Can you tell us what they were doing?
Using the headlights of an old Ford so they could strip the thing. I yelled out to them, "I'll call the cops."
So they loaded up their car and drove off, tooting and hollering and yelling obscenities at me in Mexican.
You speak Spanish, sir?
No, I do not.
Tell me about the car they were driving.
It was an old Ford. I didn't catch the license number.
You gonna tell me what I wanna know, or do I have to drag it out of you?
You should learn to talk to older people with some manners, you son of a bitch.
After the Mexicans left, you didn't go anywhere near the car?
After I scared them off? No, I didn't go anywhere near that car.
You went out to the car. Once they were gone, you had to take a look for yourself.
I was curious. Ain't a law against that. So what if I took a look around that car? You can't be accusing me of nothing.
What exactly did you see them take?
They was working on the tires. That's all that was took.
Right. So what did you take, Jacobs? Do you want my partner to pat you down?
I found a notebook in the glove compartment. I was gonna show you. It's on the chair on my porch.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Jacobs. You can speak to Officer Thibault about signing a formal statement.
When you get the car out of the way, maybe you could come back and do something about those kids.
How about we bring you an umpire's mask?
Okay, so we have the owner of the vehicle, a degenerate. I'll run John Madsen by R&I. Contact details on a William Dewey. This looks like business rather than pleasure.
I think we've wrung this place dry. Let's find a game well.
Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Could you run the name Dewey Brothers? Possibly a dealership or car mechanics workshop.
Brothers Packard Dealership, 629 Figueroa Street.
Got it. Can you put me through to Michigan 2458, please?
Connecting you now.
Hello, can I help you?
LAPD, ma'am. Can I speak to John Madsen, please?
He's at school, officer. What's this about? Is he in trouble?
How old is your boy, ma'am?
Just turned 16.
Wrong person, Mrs. Madsen. Sorry to disturb you.
Messages, please.
There's just one message for you, Detective. A four-door Packard, diplomatic license number Paul Robert 706, was reported missing this morning by Juan Francisco Valdez.
Could you have him brought in?
He's already here at Central, Detective. He's demanding an audience, as he calls it.
Thanks. Can you get a message to Captain Leary? Tell him we'll be in as soon as we can. Thanks, ma'am. Can you cordon off this lot until we have the vehicle impounded?
Yes, sir, Detective.
We'll follow up on the owner. Get a statement from Jacobs, and I'll read your report back at the station.
Cola King is the king in refreshments, ice cold.
Ask for it at your neighborhood Founders. Or pick up some at your local grocers in the easy take-home carton at all six.
We can visit the Packard dealership or head back to Central and interview this Valdez character. Your call.
Hey, look out for the pedestrians.
This has got to be the 50th abandoned vehicle call we have got this year. One more and I'm going to go crazy.
Not your favorite cases?
You kidding me? This is barely even police work. All the bad guys in this city, we get lumped with the ones who can't even be bothered to keep what they steal.
Marina's officer needs help. 333 South Main Street. 333 South Main Street. Officer needs help. 211, the shots fired. Unit to handle code 3, identify.
We got a holdup gone sour. Three guns locked themselves in with two hostages. I tried to go on through the front, but the place is a fortress. I nearly got a mouthful of lead from my trouble.
All right. I'll see if I can get in through the back.
All right, I'll stay here and keep them busy.
Let's go.
Whoa!
What are we waiting for? The gun. Stay down.
Quick, up the stairs. Get after him.
Weapon down now.
Car 11K. I've been involved in a shooting at 333 South Main Street, Globe Loan and Jewelry. It's code 4 now, but the suspect is down. I need an ambulance here, and notify my supervisor and the coroner.
11K, roger on the ambulance and coroner. Your supervisor will be notified. All units, 11K reports code 4 on the shooting at 333 South Main Street, Globe Jewelry and Loan.
Look out!
Yes, sir.
Don't tell me, let me guess. You were making your way past the lot, caught sight of the new model four-door, and couldn't help yourself. You could see yourself in that car and just had to take a closer look. Well, I can't say as I blame you.
LAPD, Mac. We'd like to speak with the owner.
That's me, William Dewey, proprietor, at your service.
We're investigating the theft of a Packard belonging to the Argentine embassy. Are you missing a combination wrench?
I don't know, Detective, but I know how we can find out. Follow me. We keep all our tools in here.
Mind if we look around?
Be my guest. You sure you guys aren't interested in a new car? Huh? Maybe a used car. I have some nice used cars for guys in your wage bracket.
Why don't you give us some alone time, Dewey? Go sell some cars or whatever it is that you do.
One left.
Gabriel Delgado is missing a three-quarter. No good. We need diplomatic plates.
This doesn't pertain to the case. It doesn't appear to be connected. Incidental.
If you don't mind, we have a few questions. Where can we find Delgado?
I don't know. He sure as hell isn't here.
Address, Dewey, or my partner shoves her head in a car door.
Okay, all right. Apartment 3, 103 Hill Street. And tell him from me, if he ever shows his face around here again, I'm gonna kick his butt from here to Kingdom Come.
A wrench from this dealership was used to strip the wheels from a Packard last night, Mr. Dewey. A couple of Hispanics were seen taking parts.
We've had a spate of thefts ourselves. Comes with the location. Even bastards to steal anything the minute your back is turned.
That's it.
Like I said, the workshop's too close to the street. It's difficult to keep an eye on it.
Packards are great cars,
But this doesn't look like the kind of place favored by foreign embassies. How do you know Valdez?
I don't know Valdez. The embassy bought the car. All I know is he must know a quality car when he sees one.
Angle with Valdez.
The embassy bought the car. When it comes in for service, Valdez picks it up. That's it.
We'll be keeping an eye on you, Dewey, and spreading the word that you don't like to cooperate with the LAPD.
We really ought to take more time over the Packard, Phelps. Let's head back to the empty lot.
God's name would want that. I don't know. People scoffed at the idea of talking in color. Look what we have now.
EGPL to any unit. The 459, they're now at 267 South Main. Unit to handle code 2, identify.
Francisco Valdez in for questioning.
Sure do, Phelps. Your bird's an interview, too. And get this, he's wearing gloves and doing his best not to touch anything. Can you beat that?
Sounds like we don't want to keep this guy waiting. It's this way.
Guy gave his wife a tab. I said, all sharing.
Ladies, how often does this
happen? Gosh, Mom, pancakes. That smells awful good.
Yes, fresh pancakes made with Mullingar flour. Mullingar makes it so easy. Just add milk and those tender, delicious pancakes are ready after a few minutes on the griddle. In fact, Mullingar flour can be used for breakfast, lunch, and supper. For meals that are satisfying, good eating, and make your mouth water, use Mullingar flour. By the same family for generations. Mullingar flour was the first to use steel rollers to process grain into the high-quality flour moms love.
Mom, we're out of hunger!
You can cheer up, son. Call the grocer. A new shipment of Mullingar flour arrives every week. Mullingar flour.
Okay, let's see what Gabriel has to say for himself.
I just hope our archangel hasn't already flown.
What the hell is this guy doing?
Hey, that's that cop. Seems like a decent guy.
Slow down!
You're a modest little person with much to be modest about.
Why is the word abbreviation so long?
Where do you see a number 3 marked on that door?
Yet.
LAPD, ma'am. We're looking for Gabriel Delgado.
Gabriel?
We're from the police. Policia, you understand?
Yes, I understand. Could you come inside?
What is your name?
Ana Rodriguez.
Is Gabriel Delgado here, Ms. Rodriguez?
No. What do you want with Gabriel? Is he in trouble?
Stay where you are, Ms. Rodriguez. We need to take a look around.
But he is not here. I have told you.
Check out the surrounds. I'll stay with the broad. So how far along are you, Anna?
Nearly 20 weeks.
Right. So how's it going to be when you go into labor and he's not around?
You are wrong about Gabriel. He will be a good father. Already he works hard to provide for us.
Unless you help us here, Anna, your little one won't be seeing Papa for a very long time.
Circumstantial. This isn't what we're looking for. Not everything here is going to be relevant.
Serving breakfast for two, Anna? You should have cleared up. Valdez gets his wheel back.
No good to me.
Diplomatic license plates.
Not sure this means much. I don't think so.
Really ought to take more time over the Packard, Phelps. Let's head back to the empty lot. Difficult to tell whether it's the suspect vehicle from the scene. Certainly Gabriel's pride and joy. You're in serious trouble, Miss Rodriguez.
But Gabriel is not here. I have done nothing wrong.
Tell us the truth, Anna. Has Gabriel been here?
I haven't seen him for at least 3 nights.
You keep lying to me, and I'll send you and your baby to jail.
He lives here, but he hasn't come home. I swear it.
Enough, Anna. There are signs all over this place that he's been back.
He was here last night. I have never seen him so angry. He went out to his shed and put some things in it. I don't know what, and I don't want to know. I love him.
Why did he steal the car, Anna?
The customer insulted him. He has his honor, no?
He steals cars to support you and care for the baby?
How can you say that? What makes you say that? I have my own job. I work at Union Station. If I have to, I will bring up our baby. That is all I have to say to you.
We found a license plate matching our stolen vehicle in the shed. Add in the assortment of parts, and we can make Gabriel for a dozen other thefts. It's time to get serious, Anna.
You must ask these questions of Gabriel. I know nothing of these car parts.
Then tell us where he is. If your baby is born in prison, Anna, the corrections officers will take it from you. You will see your son or daughter through a metal grate for half an hour a week.
The start line is on 1st and Santa Fe. There is a spillway under the bridge that leads to the river. Many policia have wrecked trying to follow him.
We will put in a good word for you, Anna. As far as we're concerned, this sits with Gabriel.
Startline? That sounds like a street race to me. It's gotten out of hand this last year. No wonder Delgado has such an eye for fine automobiles.
We know where the kid is. Let's go stop these clowns and get them off the streets.
Newspapers.
Slow down!
Thank you.
fought gallantly on distant foreign shores to secure our freedom.
That's Delgado right there.
Quick! They're getting away!
Phelps, 1247. Requesting assistance at 1st and Santa Fe. Reports of an illegal street audience.
Stay on Delgado.
Delgado is our boy. Forget the others.
Get in the way.
Gonna lose him.
Under arrest for Grand Theft Auto.
Fuck you, puto! You should speak to the maricón! Valdez, I shot him! Now who's the man? I should've burned his fucking car!
You got a foreign dignitary outed as a fruit and a kitty raper, a car dealer we're gonna let slide for the kickbacks, and a street punk car thief who sure as hell won't be taking liberties with other people's autos again anytime soon. That, Detective Phelps, is not a bad haul. You keep your chin low and your hands high, and you keep bringing me clearances just like that one. That's textbook policing, and we need more of it in this department.
You have any plans for weekend liberty, Jack?
My sisters have been working in Los Angeles in a bomber factory. They're coming down to visit. I'm meeting them at the station at 6.
Good for you, Jack. Are they cute?
They're my sisters, Hank.
Attention! Final inspection before liberty.
Good job, Kelso.
Are we going somewhere, gentlemen? Full inspection! It had better be exceptional if any of you want liberty this weekend. Kelso, this carbine. The bore is dirty.
No, it isn't.
Are you arguing with me, Kelso?
Do what you need to do, Sergeant. You know the bore is immaculate.
Weekend liberty canceled. 2-day field drill.
Clean this rifle.
No.
Do you know the penalty for insubordination, Kelso?
Jack, don't do it.
Forget him, Hank. He doesn't have what it takes.
Are you two finished?
Are you going to clean this rifle?
No, Sergeant. Cole is right. I'm going to stop playing games and join a rifle company and fight the real enemy.
Gentlemen, I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there, see if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
Need a drink. I got the jitters again. I say we bust in.